Welcome back, guys. I got in a little bit of an accident yesterday. The neck is pretty stiff. Can't really turn it too much, but the Fortnite news must go out. We've got some stuff to talk about. We are going to talk about how Epic yesterday shut down one of the most prominent leakers. We're talking shutdown. Cease and desist letters, had to delete all their accounts, or they were going to have to go to court. We're going to talk about that. We're going to talk about the status of the Infinity Blade and Mythic weapons as a whole, because it looks like the Infinity Blade is just the first one. But before we get into it, I wanted to show you guys, check it out. Hopefully you can see it on the camera. I've got the light there, but I'll hold it back here. There you go. The new G Fuel flavor is out and I haven't tried it yet. Blue Chug Rug, but it's sour. I love sour stuff. So definitely gonna give it a go. But if you get any, make sure to use promo code CHAOS. Link is in the description. Let me know if you do. Now, let's get into the leaker getting shut down. Then we'll talk about the Infinity Blade. So we're over on Fortnite News. We're gonna look at a couple different articles, okay? And they say, it happened. After months of cracking down on leakers, Epic Games has sent a cease and desist letter. If you don't know what that is, it's basically a warning. It's saying, you cease your operations, but we're going to take you to court and we're going to sue you or whatever. And they went after FNBR Leaks, which is probably the biggest leaker in Fortnite in the community, whose real name is Preston. And Preston had leaked item shops through data mining, showcased upcoming cosmetics and more. Now, he's not the only one to do this. There are hundreds, if not thousands, of people that do this, but he's the biggest one. So that's probably why Epic's lawyers went after him. It's the whole, if you cut the head off the snake, maybe the rest of them will go away, right? And we talked about this in the past, where the One Jaren and Sheena BR had to stop leaking because they got letters as well. And they had said something about they thought Preston got the letter too. So Jaren says, Epic is seriously cracking down on leaking. I got a cease and desist letter from their attorney because of the gifting leaks I did a while back. I also believe that FNBR Leaks got one too. And he was right. You guys can see it right here. According to this letters to demand that Preston immediately cease and desist from circumventing security measures Epic has put in place to prevent access from copyrighted protected code. I'll put a link in the description if you want to check out the rest of this or if you want to read the whole thing. Now, he's not going to court, okay? Because he ceased all his operations and he deleted all his accounts, his Twitter, his Instagram, everything. He had to wipe it out. He had to cease to exist when it comes to being a Fortnite leaker. Now, this site, Fortnite News, wanted to put in their article because, I mean, where's the line? Okay, because you have these news outlets that claim they claim to be news and they're reporting the data mine leaks. They're probably worried because Epic could go after them. They say, we here at FNBR News have leaked a lot of Fortnite content in the past. However, we sourced the leakers who have done so. Our most noticeable leaks were brought to us from an anonymous source, which means that ourselves are reporting the news. They are trying to bid and pitch their case that they are not leakers. We do not advertise ourselves as Fortnite leakers, and we will never do so. They say they're happy that Preston didn't get sued, and they say that their support a creator code got revoked last week for unknown reasons. They don't know why, and I don't know. That could be Epic setting up to go after not only leakers, but websites that report the leaks. And if that's the case, then YouTubers that report the leaks off the websites, they could be in trouble too. So we'll have to see what happens. Now, let's go over to Fortnite Intel. We're gonna read that article, then we'll get into the Infinity Blade. You guys are gonna get a kick out of that one, okay? This is not the first time Epic has attempted to stop those who leak, okay? I'm not going to go into specifics. This is from Preston last night. Due to the request of an Epic Games attorney, who I'm not going to disclose, my Twitter, my Discord, my YouTube, my Instagram, and GitHub must be deleted, or else they will take action. Thank you for all the support and followers over my 7-month span of the Twitter. Sadly, it comes to an end. Thank you, Preston, aka FNBR Leaks. They told him he had to literally scrub himself from the internet. And here's the deal, man. That is a small price to pay. I know he's not going to make any more income off this, but you don't want to go to court against somebody like Epic, who probably has just lawyers on retainers everywhere, powerful lawyers, and you have you can't plead your case. I mean, you're essentially hacking into their code, or you're doing whatever you're doing, which is against their terms of service. You have no case. So they could take him and really, really make him pay if they took him to court. So the fact that they sent him the letter and gave him the option to go ahead and discontinue all his operations. Honestly, they threw the guy a bone. I know it sounds rough, but it could have been way worse. A cease and desist letter is a document sent to an individual to stop illegal activity. The letter may warn the recipient does not discontinue, then other actions will be taken and they can sue. Epic has yet to take any further preventative measures to stop players from digging around. Multiple other leakers in the community have shared their stuff. We already talked about that. So, I don't know. It's going to be interesting to see how Epic handles this because they went after the biggest leaker and he's done now. So is there going to be a domino effect of the smaller leakers? I'm telling you right now, there's still going to be people leaking. You're not going to be able to expunge all of them. But how far does that trickle down? Does it trickle down to like Fortnite Intel or Fortnite News? Does it trickle down past that to the YouTubers like myself? Or, Ali A or T-Martin or Hollow or anybody else? Courage, whoever reports or talks about Fortnite leaks? Does it come down to us? We're going to have to wait and see. Okay, now let's talk about the Infinity Blade, the mythic weapon. I did a video pretty focused on this yesterday saying I don't agree with it. I think it should be its own LTM. I think it is messing with the core of the game. The fact that it was in the Winter Skirmish and these people grinded hours upon hours to qualify under a certain meta and then they get this thrown at them, the planes, is another story as well. It's just, it's not right. But for some reason, Epic is like holding on to this. We're going to get into that. So, you look over on Twitter, everybody is upset about this. Courage said, okay, all jokes aside, how on earth is a sword still in the game in its current state? I absolutely love Epic, and 95% of what they do in the game is great, but this is fundamentally ruining Fortnite. Please just make it an LTM, and everybody will be happy. And he's not the only one. It's literally every big Fortnite prominent streamer, YouTuber, competitive pro, all of them. We talked about this yesterday. Epic wants to be taken seriously in the competitive scene with Fortnite, but you can't do that when you have a $1 million tournament and you throw planes in there and then you throw in this mythic weapon, which just makes everything completely unbalanced. Well, Epic decided to address the community about the Blade. So we are over on their Reddit post, my friends. I'm going to read it with you guys and see if you catch the little fine print in here, okay? Let's talk about the Infinity Blade. Hey, you folks. We released the Mythic Infinity Blade item with the V7.01 update and have since seen a healthy amount of discussion and feedback around. It's not a healthy amount of discussion. It's literally everybody said mob mentality, get it out of the core thing. In response to what we've seen, we're looking to provide more context on the item's philosophy and some upcoming changes to the Blade. That tells you right there, it's not going anywhere. The presence of mythic items in gameplay is to provide an interaction a step above legendary items' functionality and something you'll continue to see. Let me stop right there. Did you read the fine print? Did you catch that? The presence of mythic items. Not item, not singular, not one blade, plural. Mythic items, which means there are going to be more mythic items added into the core game. And the next part in there, this is something you'll continue to see. You'll continue to see the presence of mythic items. And I've already heard people saying that other mythic items have been leaked. So I want to know in the comment section, what do you think the next mythic item is going to be? Is it going to be Thor's hammer? Is it going to be Mjolnir? You guys let me know. So let's go on and see how they justify keeping this in, okay? It says, to us, that means changing the way the game is played for those who interact with that item. The addition of items in this tier provide new and flavorful ways to interact with the map and generally shake up normal play across default modes. We'll have some more info with regards to our competitive philosophy when it comes to new items, updates, and seasons within Fortnite early next week. So, let's go in to the changes here, all right? We've got some Infinity Blade changes. The change we're currently planning for the Infinity Blade in our V7.10 update is to remove the ability to build and harvest when you're using the blade. Right now, you can use the blade or you can switch over to your pickaxe, and I do believe you can harvest. I think you can harvest with the blade, honestly. I'm not for sure. Or you can switch off of it and you can build, which is obviously overpowered in its own right. When designing the Infinity Blade, the goal was to provide a weapon with inherent risk to balance out the great capability it provides. The ability to harvest build removes a great deal of that risk. By taking away the ability to harvest and build, we hope to tune the Infinity Blade to where it feels risky to have, but still satisfying to wield. After this removal, we'll continue to monitor the blade's effectiveness and make adjustments as necessary, as well as communicate those changes. Thank you so much for your discussion and feedback around the Infinity Blade. The feedback and the discussion from the community was take it out of the core game. It makes no sense. put it in an LTM, let people have fun with it, not nerf it or try to make it fit in with what you're doing. And that is not the answer everybody wanted, my friends. It's not. And they made sure to slip in there that this is just the first one. There's going to be more mythic weapons added. And I don't know. I don't know if they're serious about their competitive views and they want to be established over there, or are they just trying to cater to the masses or the younger people that maybe like this kind of stuff. I don't know. But there is a rift, no pun intended, that is created because of this. So I'll keep you guys posted. Let me know your thoughts on it. Let me know your thoughts on everything we talked about. Make sure if you get the new flavor, hope you guys can see that on camera. It's a bright light there. Use promo code CHAOS. I'll see you guys soon.